The United States' much-publicized campaign against Huawei, the Chinese telecom and mobile phone giant, has been dragging on for months.
I'm open doors for Beijing spy masters.
Huawei is not owned, controlled, or influenced by the Chinese government.
It includes that effective ban on Huawei equipment from U.S. networks and block on Huawei from buying American technology without approval. But some current and former officials from the U.S. and its allies have told Reuters that they believe the Trump administration was initially slow to act over some of the alleged cybersecurity risks relating to 5G, including urging other countries to ban Huawei, which is the industry leader. In fact, Australia, not the United States, took the early lead in warning about Huawei and 5G. Australia had for some time been focusing on 5G security risks, and by 2018 was already pressing Washington about the perceived threat posed by 5G in Huawei's hands. Castle Brian Lowe is on the team that uncovered the story.
So intelligence officials in Australia were looking into security concerns around 5G technology and any risks posed by Chinese telecom equipments like Huawei. And as part of that, what they did was they conducted a theoretical exercise looking at what attacks could Australia theoretically mount if it had 5G equipment in other countries. What they found was the capability for offensive attacks was so great that if the tables were turned, they wouldn't be able to defend themselves. These findings alarmed them so much that this was a key part of their decision last summer to effectively ban Chinese companies like Huawei from taking part in 5G networks.
The US and Australia fear 5G could be exploited for spying and sabotaging infrastructure. Huawei has always flatly denied that it has been a party to espionage and says it would never install backdoors in its products that would allow Beijing to spy on other countries. The United States has also never publicly produced hard evidence that Huawei equipment has been used for spying. Still, Australia took its concerns to its allies, including during a visit in early 2018 to the States by then Prime Minister Malcolm Turnbull. One Australian source told Reuters that the U.S. was receptive to Australia's concerns, but that restricting Huawei from 5G networks didn't seem a high priority at the time.
What this shows is that despite the U.S.'s very public vocal campaign to get other countries to ban Huawei from 5G, it wasn't necessarily the first to act on this. And indeed, Australia appears to be out ahead in both focusing on 5G concerns, but also pressing others to take action. The US will say its end goal is to get allies to ban Huawei from 5G altogether. Ultimately, it remains very early days for 5G, with networks only just being rolled out. The security debate will no doubt rage on in the years ahead.